Okay, I've zoomed in on the guy's shirt, and there's this funny U-shaped damaged area where it's kind of light, and the easiest way to fix that is with a mask. But it's a really odd shape, and it's mottled too. So to create a mask for it, we're going to use the fuzzy select tool, and it looks like a magic wand over here. So we're going to click on that. Come down here to where it says threshold, and this adjusts the sensitivity on how the wand works. And you're just going to have to do a bunch of guesswork and figure out the setting that you want. And in this situation, I want it at 20. Next, click on a damaged spot inside the area you want to fix and see if the mask is the shape that you want. In this case, it is, but if it wasn't, I would just click on a different color inside the damaged area and the mask shape will change. Go over to the eyedropper tool and click on it, and then come over onto the picture, and in this case I'm going to choose a gray that's a little darker than I want, and I'm going to click on that and use that for my fill color. The mask included his t-shirt, which I don't want to change, so I can't use the bucket fill tool. Instead, I'm going to use a brush. The brush I've chosen is number 2, hardness 0.75, and I have the opacity set about 46%. I've got a really big brush, and now I'm going to do a drag over the area that I want to change and stay away from that t-shirt. And if I go back and forth over the area the same more than once, it won't change anything unless I release the button and then click it again. Then it's like doing it twice, and it'll be even darker, which you don't want to do. So it's one drag without releasing the button. That looks better, but there's still a spot that's too light. So I'm going to zoom back in, and I'm going to choose the fuzzy select tool, and I'm going to change the threshold to 10. And then I'm going to come over here and click it to choose this area. Go back to my brush tool, come over here over the mask on the right-hand side of it, and click. And that fixed that area. I probably should have made my brush a little bit bigger, but you get the idea. By using the opacity setting, I was able to get rid of all those blurs, but keep this wrinkle in the plate of his shirt and the button. And that's the basics on using the fuzzy select tool. There is one other spot on this shirt I want to fix, and it's right over here. It's the flap on the pocket. I'm going to use the clone tool to fix it. I've chosen the shadow right here under the flap, but I'm not going to do a drag. I'm going to do a bunch of individual clicks, because I need to recreate the curve that's missing on the flap. There you go. And that's it for this one. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. If you liked it, a thumbs up is greatly appreciated. Thanks for watching. God bless. Bye.